Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about dimensionless quantity. Make sure you watch dimensional analysis part 1 to part 3. Then go ahead with part 4. Here we will cover topics definition of dimensionless quantity, dimension of gravitational constant, and then we will find dimensions of Planck's constant, gas constant, and Boltzmann constant. So what are dimensionless quantities? These are the quantities which have no units. They have only numbers but don't have any units. So they also have no dimension. And as they have no dimension, so the dimension of dimensional quantity is considered as 1. Keep in mind, it's not 0. Most people think it's 0, but it's 1, not 0. All the numbers like 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 9, and some constants are dimensionless. Here is the list of constants which are dimensionless, like pi, its value is 3.14 and it has no unit, also no dimension. The same way coefficient of friction, that is mu, it also has no unit and so no dimension. Refractive index of medium and Poisson ratio, these two also have no units and no dimension. Special functions like log, exponential is like e raised to the power x, and also log, and also ln, that's base is 10, and all the trigonometric functions like sine theta, cos theta, or tan theta, these are all dimensionless. That means they have no dimension and no units. But some constants have dimension. So you need to memorize that there are some constants which have dimensions and some constants which are dimensionless. I have listed dimensionless constant in the back page. Here we will find the dimension of gravitational constant. It's not dimensionless. So for that we will use the formula of force. You know, gravitational force equals g m1 m2 over r square. So we will rearrange this formula to find this capital G or gravitational constant. So for that this r square would go here and we will get f times r square and divided by m1 m2 will come here in down in the bottom. Unit of force is kilogram meter per second square and distance has meter square. For mass we have the unit kilogram or kg. So we got here, let's cancel out the same terms. So we got here meter cubed, this meter and this meter square, that would become meter cubed over second square and over kg. Let's write the dimension. So for meter, meter is the length, it would be L. Second is the time, kg is the mass. So we got m would go up, m raised to the power minus m, L cube, t would go up, then t raised to the power minus 2. This is the dimension of gravitational constant. Here is the dimension of Planck's constant. For that we will use the formula energy equals h, which is Planck's constant, times frequency, h times f. So let's rearrange formula first to get the Planck's constant, that is h equals energy over frequency. The unit of energy is, you can also write it joules, but for frequency is hertz. But if you are finding dimension, then you need units in base units. These are not base units. So for the energy, we will write kilogram meter square per second square. This is the unit of energy. And for frequency, it is cycles per second. So for kg, we can write m. For meter, we can write L square. And for time, second, we can write t square in the bottom. Cycles has no unit or no dimension, so leave it like that. So this second would be the time, would come here in the division. So this 1t would be cancelled out with 1t. So we got m L square t minus 1. This is the dimension of Planck's constant. And this is the unit of Planck's constant and also this one. They both are the units of Planck's constant. Let's find unit of gas constant. For that we need to use the formula PV equals N rt. So we need to rearrange this equation to find r. So r equals pv over nt. Here we need to plug in units of pressure, volume, these are number of moles, and temperature. Here T is temperature. So for pressure, make sure that you write units in base quantity so we can convert in the dimensions. For pressure, units are, if you don't remember the units, then in that case you can also break them. Like for pressure, you know, force over area. And for force, we have the units kilogram meter per second square. And for area, it's meter square. 1 meter would be cancelled from here and we get kilogram meter second square per second square here. So it will come in division here. So for volume, its unit is meter cube. Now plug in all the units here. So for pressure, we got kilogram meter second square. For volume, we got meter cube. For N, it's mole. And for temperature, it's Kelvin. Here 1 meter would be cancelled out by this 1 meter. So it would be meter square here. So kilogram meter square per second square mole times Kelvin. So let's plug in the dimensions here. For kg it's m. For meter it's l square. For second it's t. For mole dimension is n. And for Kelvin it's k. So ml square t raised to the power minus 2 n minus 1 k minus 1. This is the dimension of gas constant. Now the last is Boltzmann constant. So for that we can use the formula. Energy equals 3 by 2 kT. Here T is the temperature and K is the Boltzmann constant. So rearrange this formula. So K is equals 2 by 3 E over T. Here 2 by 3 is a constant. So it is a dimensionless quantity or it has no dimension. So we will plug in just unit of energy and temperature. We can also write as joule per Kelvin because a unit of energy is joule and for temperature it's Kelvin, but we have to write the units in base units. So joule equals kilogram meter square per second square divided by Kelvin. Let's plug in the dimensions. For kg it's m, for meter it's l, and for second it's t square, and for Kelvin it's k. So ml square t minus 2 k minus 1. This is the dimension of Boltzmann constant. Here is the question of the day. Solve this question to see if you get right answer. Answer is given below in the description box. If you have any question, you can ask your questions in the comment box given below. Thank you.